for this, there will never be Biafra again. Loretta Onoche drops bombshell. Tell Nnamdi Kanu. Loretta Onoche, senior special assistant on social media to President Muhammad Buhari, has said there will never be the Republic of Biafra again. She stated this on Monday following the reported attack on the Imo State Police Command headquarters and the Owerri Correctional Prison, which led to the release of over 1,800 inmates and the destruction of scores of vehicles and state assets. The former Inspector General of Police, Muhammad Adamu, had accused operatives of the Eastern Security Network, ESN, of being the masterminds behind the attacks. After the incident, Onoche tweeted a video showing the then head of state, Yakubu Gowon, receiving the then Biafran Vice President, Major General Philip Effiong, who facilitated the surrender of the Biafran state to Nigeria in 1970. Effiong had assumed leadership of the secessionist state after the Biafran leader, Colonel Chukwuemeka Ojukwu, fled to Cote d'Ivoire in the heart of the civil war. She captioned the video, "Relief on the faces of Philip Effiong, second in command to Ojukwu and his men, as the surrender says, never again Biafra." "The joy on the face of the head of state, Yakubu Gowon," says One Nigeria. "The very day nails were put in the coffin of Biafra, there will never be Biafra again, never," in May 1967. The satisfaction over the Nigerian state and quest for sovereignty led Ojukwu to declare the exit of the Republic of Biafra from Nigeria. The Biafran territory essentially comprised the southeast region of Nigeria. The declaration led to the civil war that lasted 2.5 years as the Nigerian state under Gowon battled to unify the soul of the country using state powers and military might. The war ended in January 1970 with the southeast region back in Nigeria, but the civil war left many soldiers and civilians dead. However, decades later, secessionist agitation resurfaced in the southeast. The agitation this time is being championed by the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu. The Buhari regime had in September 2017 outlawed IPOB and declared that the activities of the group constituted an act of terrorism and illegality. Before then, Kanu was arrested and jailed, but was later released from the Kuje prison in Abuja after meeting bail conditions. The IPOB leader later fled the country and has been operating from overseas. Recently, IPOB formed the Eastern Security Network, but the security outfit has no backing of the governors of the Southeast. It has therefore been at loggerheads with state-authorized security agencies like the police and the army. Thank you for listening to this news. You see, you know why I won't even like to say anything to Loretta Onoche? I won't like to say anything to her because she's ignorant. She's ignorant. She's talking about Philip Effiong. What does she know about Philip Effiong? Philip Effiong was a vice president and also a president during the war. Do you understand? Okay? That was during the Biafran war then. And even when Philip Effiong was handing over the Biafran flag to Yakubu Gowon, what did he say to Gowon? Can Loretta Onoche remind the world of what Yakubu Gowon, what Philip Effiong told Yakubu Gowon and the military troops? What did he tell him? He said, "Treat Biafrans well so that their children will not rise up in future and fight." That was the message from Philip Effiong before handing over the Biafran flag to Yakubu Gowon. But what happened? After Philip Effiong finish surrendering the flag, Jacob Gowon changed his personality. That is to tell you that at first he was innocent, but the moment the flag was handed over to him, he became a different person. He became a different person, and that is them for you, and that is how they behave. So I'm not surprised that this is happening. I'm not surprised that he's putting up this kind of look. So what's Lota Onoche saying? That there can never be another Biafra. For the fact that what Philip Effiong requested and demanded was not met, and because Philip Effiong warned Yakubu Gowon, yet Yakubu Gowon still went on to suffer the children of Biafrans. It was as if all that Philip Effiong have said will come to pass, and that is what is happening today. That is what is happening today. What is happening to the Biafrans? Are they not being tortured? Are they not being intimidated? Because of all of that, that is why Biafrans have said no, that we need to go back to our own republic. Philip Effiong, though, did something good, but he never knew that these people are going to be this kind of people. So that is why the Biafrans have decided to take back the flag from Yakubu Gowon and Buhari and pursue their republic. And now that they are pursuing it, I don't think any man born of a woman can be able to collect it back from them, because we are almost close to the line of actualization. You understand? And that is just the humble truth. So, Loreto Onoche, that is showing the video of Philip Effiong surrendering Biafran to Yakubu Gowon, I tell you that she is just blabbing. She's just blabbing and noising. Because I know that never will Biafrans give up to these puzzles. Never, I tell you, never. Biafrans have been patient enough. They have waited enough. And now it is time to break through. The time has come. So let us get hold of it. You understand? Let us get hold of it. So what are we saying? My dear viewers, so many things has been done. So many decisions has been taken. But then, Biafrans still remain absolute. Biafrans have been intimidated. They have been threatened. Yet, they still remain absolute. So tell me, what else is remaining? What else is remaining? Look at them. They are all regretting and blaming themselves. Can't you see the sign of Biafran freedom coming closer? Loreto Onoche is a blabber. That is what she's very good at. And that is why I will keep making jest of her. She can only come out to speak when she sees that the day is done, that there is nobody watching her. Why can't she come out and speak when we have the NSAS protest? Then she would have known herself. Let me hear from you and know what you have to say about this. If you are new, click on the red subscribe button, so that's the bell button to receive more updates. Thank you.